Hi, I'm Christina, technical writer for the Smart Document Camera, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the camera and get connected to a computer that's connected to a smart board display. So here we have the document camera. On the back here, you'll see an HDMI in and out port, as well as the power connection. Along the one side here, you'll see a battery indicator, a mini USB-B port, two regular USB Type-A ports, and a security lock slot. Now you may have noticed that this USB port already has something connected to it. This is the dongle for the wireless peer-to-peer connection. I'll talk about that later in this video. First, let's get this camera connected to power. Although the camera has a battery so you can use it without connecting it to power, it's a good idea to fully charge it the first time you use it. So take the included power cord and connect it to the power input under the handle. You'll see the power button light and battery indicator turn on. Now let's get this document camera connected. You can connect a few different ways to either a smart board display with the DocCam app installed or to a computer with the DocCam software installed. For complete details on the different ways to connect, make sure to check out the link in the description below. Here I have my laptop connected to a smart board. I'm going to go to the display's computer input and open up the software. Now you can connect the camera. Using the included USB cable is an easy way to do this. You can use a longer cable if you need to, but we recommend that you don't use one longer than 12 feet. Otherwise, you may experience issues. So take the USB cable and connect one end to the camera and the other end to the port on the laptop. Because I'm using a wired connection, I'll need to make sure that the camera's Wi-Fi mode is off. This blue light here tells me it's currently on. So I'll press the Wi-Fi button to turn it off. Then back in the document camera software, I should now see my camera available for connecting. To connect, simply tap the play button. A wired connection like the one I just showed is great for connecting quickly, but it does limit your ability to move the camera around. This is where the wireless connection options are great. There are a few wireless connection options. The easiest and most reliable one is the peer-to-peer method. Remember this USB port I showed earlier? This is the partner to this included Wi-Fi dongle that you can use to create a direct peer-to-peer wireless connection between the camera and your computer. This direct connection enables you to quickly connect to the camera without having to enter a password or deal with connecting to the school's network. Note that if you're using a Mac computer, there's an extra driver you'll need to install first. Again, check the link in the description below for full details. To use this method, all you need to do is take this Wi-Fi dongle and plug it into your computer. Make sure that Wi-Fi mode is on. Then in the software, you should see the camera listed. If it's not there, tap Sync. And then tap this button to connect. The camera's image will pop up once the connection is complete. So that's how you get set up and connected to the document camera software. If you'd like to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe to the Smart Support YouTube channel and keep an eye on the playlist for the Smart Document Camera 650. Thanks for watching.